Hi, I'm James with JNC Home Repair. Today I'm going to demonstrate on how to operate a voltmeter. What we have here today is a multimeter, but it measures voltage, and a voltmeter does the same thing. It's just strictly for measuring voltage. Okay, there's basically two different types of voltage that you can measure for. There's an AC current and there's a DC current. DC current is a direct current. It's what DC stands for. Basically the symbol, I don't know if you can see, there's a solid line and then there's a broken line that identifies a direct current circuit. You need to know that in case you have a diagram that's showing you the different circuits of what kind of circuit you have. That way you know if you have a direct current or an alternating current. And then that's the symbol for an alternating current, which is usually in homes, what's hooked up to the light switches, to the lights, and to the plugs. How you use this thing, if let's say you're testing for voltage inside a home, most of the voltage inside a home is 120 volts, and on your meter you always want to have it set to a setting that's higher than your voltage in your house. And on a meter it's either 200 or 600, so you want to put it on the 200 setting for a 120 volt circuit. Now, if you're measuring 220 voltage, like something going to an air conditioner, that's going to be 220 volts. You're going to want to bump up your meter to 600 volts. That way your meter is able to measure the circuit correctly, okay? And basically all what you do is, we have a switch here, or we have a plug here, okay? On this plug, the black or the gold, the brass colored screws are the hot, and on the other side the chrome colored screws are the neutral, okay? And all you do to test for voltage is get your black and red wires, and you put your black on the hot, which is the brass colored wires, and you put the red on the neutral, on the chrome colored screws. And that will give you a reading on the meter on what the voltage is. And it should be anywhere from, you know, right there at 120. It'll probably say, you know, 119, 118, whatever. But that's basically all there is to it, to using a voltmeter. You just want to make sure that it corresponds with the different types of circuits that you're measuring for. If you have any more questions concerning voltage, you can log on to my website, jnchomerepair.com.